to understand the TaxCars digital overlay lending system. The main feature of this system is very interesting for users and students, that it allows them to assemble the most involved circuits by their own hands and to study the experimental value of this circuit and visualize the actual experience of the practical knowledge of any electronic circuits. So now we move on to the circuit descriptions, and I give you brief knowledge about and all the components which are provided with these kits and some accessories which are going to use to perform the experiment and to make the circuits with this kit.
So this is our trainer kit of digital overlay learning system. The order code for this trainer kit is 33528. These are the component section. This is the user manual, and this is more than a user manual because it has lot of experiments and lot of circuit diagrams which can be made through these components and the accessories provided with them. The students can learn a very good educative value from these experiments and this user manual. These are the tracing papers for ease of access of to making the circuits with the breadboard and the components. Now we open the kit. In this kit there are lot of components. This is the resistor section. In this, the resistors are from 33 ohms to 4K7, and even 100K resistance is also provided. This is the diode, and these are the capacitors of different values. Also electrolytic capacitor, which are polar capacitors, and there is a Zener diode also provided. These are the transistors, and this is the 7-segment LED, and these are the normal LEDs to perform the experiments. Now these are the ICs of different components. These are the dip switches which are used in experiment. Now I will show you the other accessories which are provided with this kit. This is a wire stripper which will be used to strip the wire and cut the wire which are need to do the experiment. This is the breadboard circuit. These are the potentiometers, and there are the knob of potentiometers. These are the toggle switches, 4 toggle switches which will be used in the circuit. And this is the twicer which will be used with the small components which can not be able to picked up with the hands and the fingers. The tweezer is used for them. Also some hookup wires are also provided which will be easily inserted in the breadboard so the students can avoid the soldering purpose while making the circuits. This is the breadboard. This is a unique solderless large size spring-loaded breadboard consisting of 2 terminal strips with 1280 points, 80 tie points, and 4 distribution strips with 100 tie points each. In total, there are 1680 tie points on this breadboard. The size of this breadboard is 112 mm in width and 170 mm in the length, approximately. So in the breadboard, you can see in the manual, this is the distribution strip which are this section. There are 4 distribution strips. These distribution strips are internally connected horizontally from right left to right, and also these are connected horizontally which are used to given supply in the circuit. And these are the half terminal strips. This terminal strip has 5 points each and which are connected vertical direction in the both sections. So this breadboard is the main component of this kit because all the component can easily installed on this breadboard, and there is no required of soldering, which will be very easy, which will provide very ease to students to explain and design the circuits. Now we move on to our first experiment, which is to design an OR gate, and the other experiment of other part of this experiment is to design an inverter circuit also. So we are going to do the experiment. So this is the breadboard circuit design also given in the test paper, which a student can easily place the test paper on the breadboard and place the component and ICs on the breadboard. And this is the traditional circuit to explaining the working of any circuit. For this, now we will use the IC7432. Find out the IC from the IC component sections. This is the 7432 IC. Carefully remove IC from the kit. The ICs have 14 pin, 8 pin and so on. This cut shows the starting point of the IC, and the dot here is describes the terminal number 1 of the IC. So this is the terminal number 1, and this is the terminal number 2, 3, 4 and so on to 14. This is the last terminal of the IC. Hope you will see it clearly in the video. So the description of IC diagram is also provided in the manual. So we will put the IC in the breadboard. So this is the supply which we have to given to this circuit. I have set this supply to 5 volt DC, which is required in our circuit. The positive point is placed at the upper terminal of distribution strip. Carefully and properly place the wire and the ground terminal in the lower line of the terminal distribution strip. So now this is the section which have now 5 volt supplies. We can use this 5 volt supply in our circuit. For while making circuit, I will turn off the supply. So if there is no component breakage or short circuit condition occur, first we will make circuit, then we will power on the supply. So now use a toggle switch and place it any 3 points on the half terminal strips, and another switch place this in this other section of half terminal strip. Now connect one terminal of switch to ground. Because the vertical line is internally connected, I have select the first point, the switch is at the third point, but they are internally connected, the supply is passed through with this wire. The one terminal is connected to ground, same as for the second switch. One terminal we provided the ground or the negative of 5 volt DC supply. Now we need 1K2 resistance. So find out the resistance. The resistance are placed here. The first resistance, one terminal is placed with 5 volt supply, you can see in the circuit, and the other terminal placed on the first pole of the switch. Similarly, the other 1K2 resistance will be placed in the switch and I will place it to nearby any free point and I will extend the resistance with this wire to the 5 volt supply. Now on the IC section, take one wire from the middle point of the switch and put it on the number one terminal of the ICs. Similarly, again take a wire from the half terminal strip of switch and put it to the second number pin of the IC. Now take a wire and put it to the third pin of this IC and remove this wire, place this wire as it is. This will be give our output. Now for power the IC, connect ground terminal to the terminal number 7 of the IC and positive 5 volt to the terminal number 14 of the IC. Properly place the wire so that while experiment you will not remove any loose connection. If there is a loose connection, your circuit won't work properly. Now once again verify the circuit with the circuit diagram. We have verified our circuit which is working. Now we power on the device. The 5 volt is supplied to this terminal strip. Now circuit is in work, have started doing work. Now we have designed an OR gate circuit, so we will verify the truth table of OR gate with this circuit. At this point the output will come when we connect a multimeter between this and ground. So set the multimeter on 5 volt or DC supply. The positive terminal to the output number, output terminal, which is IC's third number terminal. Now at this time both the switches are on zero position, so our output will be zero. This is the zero you can see in the multimeter. Now I turn one of a switch to one. So now according to the truth table our output should be 5 volts, which is the high input in the DC. So you can see at the multimeter this is the output from the IC. Now again I turn the first switch back to 0 and the other switch to the 1 and check the output. You can see the 5 volt output is coming from the IC. Now turn both the switch to one position and the output will be 1. So That's how we verify the truth table of OR gate, and we have made the circuit of OR gate. Now we move on to our second experiment, which is the inverter circuit. Now we will make the circuit of inverter circuit. For this, place the positive to the distribution strip. This is the 5 volt positive and this is the ground. Properly place the wire in the breadboard circuit. Always switch off the supply while making the circuit. Now we need IC7404 for this inverter circuit. So let me find out the IC. This is the 7404 IC. Take it out and place it to the breadboard at any point. If you find difficulty to place the IC, use the tweezer and align the pins of the IC properly like this and properly place the IC on the breadboard. Now we will take a switch. Put it on the breadboard. Now we need a 1K2 resistance and it will be connected between first terminal of the switch and to the 5 volt supply. The other terminal of the switch will be given the ground and the center terminal, which is the output from the switch. Will be connected to the first pin of the IC. Now we need a 330 ohm resistance which will be connected to the second number terminal of IC, which gives the output, and we will put at the blank half terminal strip. Now we will connect an LED . Always check the direction of this LED, that the bigger terminal is the anode and the smaller terminal is the cathode. So connect the anode of this LED to the other end of resistance and the other end of this LED will be connected to ground. So this is our circuit. Now we give the power to the IC. For this, positive 5 volt will be given to the 14th pin of this IC and negative will be given to the 7th pin of this IC. So this is our circuit has been done. Always verify the circuit before starting the power. So we have verified our circuit. Now to test the circuit, we will power on. At this time the switch is at one position and output is not on, output is zero. Now I put the switch on zero and you will see the output is one. The LED is glowing, which showing the output is one. So this is the inverter circuit with this 7404 IC, and we have built the circuit here. And is it working? The truth table of this inverter circuit is verified when I give 0. When I give 1, the output is 0, When I give 0, the output is 1. So that's the inverter circuit. So there are a lot of circuits and experiments in this manual which can be designed and performed and get the practical experience from this kit properly to the users and students. Now I will suggest you something, that whenever you deassemble the circuit, always place the component on the same position where you taken out from the kit, so you will not lose any component for the future purpose. And your component will be placed properly. And if any case you find difficulty to remove this IC, that you can see the IC is very tightened in this breadboard, use this tweezer, slightly push the IC and take it out and place it to its place so that your component will never misplaced anywhere. Make the kit properly with all the components. So this is the practical training of digital overlay learning system from the Tesca. For any queries, users, please refer user manual, or you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Thank you.